Video 4.9 Home Automation. In this video, we will cover the following topics: creating a remote control sprite, interfacing a CFL to a relay and Raspberry Pi, controlling the CFL using the remote control sprite we created. To do home automation, we have to connect an appliance to the Raspberry Pi with the help of a relay. First, let us look into the connection for this. The components that we need are Raspberry Pi, a relay, external power supply, jumper cables, a lamp holder and wires, a CFL. Since we are using a two-channel relay, we will connect the CFL to one of these relays. Pin IN1 is for turning on the first relay. Now let us make the connection of the external power supply. Connect VCC of the relay to the VCC of the external power supply. Connect the GND pin of the relay to the GND of the external power supply. And then connect this common ground to the GND pin of the Raspberry Pi. Now connect IN1 of the relay to GPIO pin 2 of the Pi. Then connect the wires of the CFL lamp to the COM port and the NO port of the relay output. Now turn on the power supply for the external power supply board, the CFL lamp and the Raspberry Pi. Now let us go to the programming part. First, we will create a remote control sprite for controlling the working of the CFL. For this, I have created four sprites: a sender button, two arrow buttons and a stop button. Let us learn how to create these buttons. First, we will create the sender button, and for this, we have to select this circle option and draw a circle. You can choose the color of the button as you wish. Next, I am selecting the rectangle shape to draw a rectangle in the button to make it look a little better. Make sure to give different colors to them and then group them both. Next, we will learn how to make the arrow buttons. Select this rectangle shape and draw the rectangle. Now we have to select the reshape option to reshape this rectangle into an arrowhead. Copy this arrowhead image and create a new sprite. Paste the copied arrowhead here and rotate it to point in another direction. For creating stop button, I have to just draw a small red circle. Now that the sprites have been created, let us look into the programming part. We have used the when the sprite is clicked start block to run the code. Initially, we will adjust the sprite's initial position when the program starts using the go to XY block, and then adjust the size using the set size to block. Next, the Raspberry Pi extension blocks are selected, and from it, this GPIO output block is selected. We have used the up arrow sprite to turn on the lamp and down arrow sprite to turn off the lamp. When we press the up arrow sprite, the GPIO pin 2 should be high to turn on the lamp. For that, we will select pin 2 from this GPIO output block and make the second option high. When we press the down arrow sprite, the lamp should turn off, and for that, we have made the option of this GPIO block low. Next, when we press the sender button, I want the lamp to turn on and off continuously. For this to work, we have to make GPIO pin 2 high and then make it low. In between these GPIO blocks, we have to put the wait seconds block to make the lamp work properly. Now for the stop sprite, we will use the stop block for making all other code to stop operating. Now let us check out the working in real time. Now here is an activity for you. Connect two CFLs to the relay and control them using the touch sensor. Using two different sensors to turn on these two CFL and other two to turn them off separately. Later try to program them and make them turn on and off together and alternatively also. It should be fun. Summary: In this video, we have covered the following topics: creating a remote control sprite, interfacing a CFL to a relay and Raspberry Pi, controlling the CFL using the remote control sprite we created. Section summary. In this section, we have covered the following topics: physical computing with Raspberry Pi and Scratch 3.0, sensors and actuators, LED and push button, let there be light, motion sensor, who is there in the dark, relay, touch sensor, home automation. In the next section, we will learn how to make fun games and smart musical instruments using Scratch 3 and Raspberry Pi.